Hey everyone, it's Laz again. Not the full episode, number 4, not yet. Working on it, taking a look at the topics that I really want to put in there to help you out with your CCNA 200-125. And that's exactly what all of you need to be focused on, is that particular certification. All right, so with that said, this little video, all right, it's going to be your Etherchannel. All right, why would you use Etherchannel? How would you configure it? Basic. General stuff. Very doubtful you'll configure Etherchannel. You may get a print screen, you may get some multiple choice questions, you may get a drag and drop, I don't know. Alright, but you're definitely not going to be configuring Etherchannel, but hey, I'll show it to you. Yes, this is a blank packet tracer, but we're going to go ahead and put things from scratch, right? We'll build the network from scratch so you can do the same thing at home. So let's go ahead and do that. So first, I'm going to go ahead and take out 2 PCs, alright? And then I'm gonna get my switches, they're gonna be 2960. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, this is the CCNA. It's layer 2 switching. Layer 2 switching, not layer 3. Okay? Not layer 3. Once you get to your CCNP and above, you'll get, you get to the next CCNA, which is February 24th, 2020. So hurry the hell up and get certified, okay? Yeah. Then you better worry about layer 3 switches and all that. All right, we're gonna get plug in our PC2 here. We'll put it on port 20. And again, people ask me a lot, what do you plug things into? Are they supposed to be plugging into the port? I plug them into whatever port I feel like. All right, not to be a jerk or anything, just so I know visually what I need to do. So if it's port 24, I know port 24 is gonna be my switch. All right, connected to my F00, G00, whatever zero on my router. It's your network. Do what you want so you can visually already recognize what is it that you're looking at. That's why in the router descriptions, on your switch, it's nice to have to know where you're connecting through. All right, so we're gonna get the lightning bolt here. When you use the lightning bolt, it's gonna use the correct cable that you need. And it's only gonna pick the first available port, as you can see, F01. So the next one will be F02. And then F03. Now, for whatever reason, I find myself using this fast forward in time button, looking back to the future, all right, in order to get things moving along a little bit quicker. If not, I'll be sitting there forever. So let's put in IP addresses. I wouldn't have any layer 3 information, so we're not routing or anything like that. So we're in the same network, 192.168.1.1. Tap, tap. Easy, right? I go to desktop, boom. We go 192.168.1.2, tab tab, right, using the default mask. And we can ping right now if we wanted to. I mean, it's not that we can ping. Ping 192.168.1.2, and we can ping. You're not gonna see it going, it wants to do Etherchannel going 100 miles or 300 megabits per second, because that's the whole point of Etherchannel. The whole point of Etherchannel is for you to aggregate, bring these three links. Because you see on the left, on switch number 3, you have 2 AMR ports, which you're not gonna have, all right? In the CCNA certification, you're not gonna have ports being lit up and stuff like that. You're just gonna have bridge IDs. What is that? It's a priority number, and it's a MAC address, all right? That creates the bridge ID, which is for the span tree. But that's span tree that's doing that. So what you're doing when you're aggregating the ports, not only are you bringing it into one port channel, all right, where all the information is going through to increase your bandwidth to 300 megabits per second, but you're also tricking spanning tree. Hey, this is one port, okay? So if you look at it, this is the switch that is choosing to block the port on, and you'll see it, all right? And I'm sure in your test, you'll be able, let's give it a name, so we know where we're at. This is, switch 3, okay? Conf T, host name, SW, just put in caps. I'm not screaming, yes, I can't see it. All right, do WR. You can't do the do, you cannot do the do in your certification. You have to go back to privilege mode and do copy, run, start, enter, enter. Why twice? Because you gotta save it to the start of the configuration file, right? That's where you save stuff to. So, anyway. I don't need to be there. I just need to put the whole thing. I'm gonna go ahead and do a, what was I looking for? Okay, the ports, there you go, shows pantry. Shows pantry. Show spanning tab, there we go. Good last. Alright, as you can see, we have two block ports, alright, ports 2 and 3. What we're gonna do is we're gonna aggregate these three ports. We're gonna create Etherchannel, we're gonna create a port channel, and we're gonna include these interfaces in that port channel. These will be trunk channels, trunk ports. The channel is trunk and the ports are trunk. Now, once we get into that, we'll put the type of channel group that we want to use. There's some mode that you can choose. It's active, passive, active, auto, reliable, just on. All right, you gotta know the differences between each. All right, so that is what we need to understand. So these are the ports. This is not the bridge. All right, this is, doesn't say it. It would say it right here, because this information right here is about the root bridge. So this guy has a lower MAC address than this guy. So that's why he became the root bridge, because all switches have that by default. All right, so let's go ahead and configure Etherchannel, and we'll start right here. Let's go ahead and open this guy up. All right, I'm gonna do config T. First, the port channel, int port channel. Okay, how many port channel? Port channel 1. All right, then we trunk it. Switch port mode trunk. Okay, that's what the T stands for, trunk. I abbreviate a lot, yes I do. All right, then we go into the range of the ports, which ports are gonna participate in this port channel 1. Okay, so we're gonna go int range F0/1-3, enter. I trunk them, switch port mode. I trunk there. Okay, so they're trunk, but now we gotta say channel hyphen group. Okay, 1. That's the channel we created. Port channel we created. Channel group 1. Mode. Ta-da! This is what you need to know. Active. Lag P, auto, pack P, desirable, pack P, on, it's just on, okay? If it's on one side, it's on the other. Passive. So if you want lag P, you can say, okay, I just want to make it active. It says unconditional, you want lag P, all right? If it's passive, well, hey, listen, you know, if you detect some other device out there that's running lag P, can you please be lag P? Yes, thank you so much, all right? We're not gonna do that. We're gonna do active, you both are gonna be lag P. Alright, or we can do auto, we can do desirable, and then they'll both be packy. But again, one will be Cisco proprietary, but the other one will be cross vendors. Alright, cross vendors. Packy, cross vendors, packy, Cisco. Alright, so we're gonna do active on both. Active. And now I'm gonna put it here, because you can actually put allowed VLANs, you can allow certain VLANs to go through. Not other VLANs. I let all the VLANs go through. I mean, the whole point, this is your backbone. This is your backbone that you're creating, right? This is where you're aggregating these links, is information is going down through floor. So think of this as the second floor to the first floor, and you want to send information, and you're still running UTP Cat5 cabling, and you have 300 nodes per floor, and you have data going down the wire, you need more bandwidth. So guess what? Aggregate the line. All right, so we got that going. I'm gonna do WR. All right, and one of the things you wanna look at is show Etherchannel summary. You can see it says S down. It's down. And it will be down because the other side's not up. So let's get the other side going. DLI, we'll do enable, 15, let's give it a name, this is switch 4. Name, that's W4. Awesome. And we're gonna do int port channel 1, trunk it, switch port mode trunk. Okay, then we go int range F0/1-3, switch port mode trunk, and then we do channel -g group. Because it's an account, So I have to type all the way to G before I can tap. One. And then mode is active. Boom. Okay, and look what it says right here. Port channel is up. All right, so what do we do? Let's control Z. Let me do WR. I'm going to do a couple and start. All right. You do that in the test. I'm going to do a show ether channel. Oh, summary. Sorry. Summary. All right, and you can see SU. It says SU. S. Obviously, where's the personal capital? I always miss that. There it is. It's layer 2. Okay. And it's in use. It's up. It's up. It's working. Okay. And now it'll tell you it's down. Well, this one said it was down. Oh, it changed state to up. Ah, because the other one is up. That is why. Okay. So if we look at show spanning tree, you can see that the port channel is the one that has the lower cost. See that? Why? Because you aggregated it. You have 300 megabits per second. That's why the cost is going to be lower, and that's going to be a root port. It's going to be a root port. This doesn't say this is a root bridge. Does it say that this is the root bridge? Let's take a look at show span tree here. Show span tree. Hey, this says this is the root bridge. Why? Because it has a lower cost. Well, at the same time, it also has a lower MAC address. Well, you can see here it has a same. Well, this is the root bridge MAC address. It is 0005. Okay, but it's really because of the lower cost. Because if I were to put gigabit, if I would have, let's say, 2 megs, and I would, it usually makes, it blocks the higher port numbers. All right, but if you have bandwidth, STP will make a decision based on bandwidth. So it will never block a gigabit port because it has a cost of 4. Fast Ethernet has a cost of 19. So if we aggregate our links, all right, and we have 300 megabits per second, definitely that's going to have a lower cost. Definitely that's going to have a lower cost. So that's what you want to look at. And also the type right here. This lets you know that that's an Ether channel port. And that's an Ether channel port. Now right there. So that's what you look at. And really that's it. What I showed you, let me fast forward through time so they turn green. There you go. Okay. So now they're all green. And you're going to see you're not going to ping any different. All right. It's going to go the same speed. You're not going to notice any difference. But the bottom line is that you can do a show Ethernet channel. Show Ethernet channel summary. I should say show Ethernet channel summary. And it'll tell you. Pay attention to that SD or SU. All right. S meaning layer 2. Okay, well, let's just look at it one more time so we can see. It's show ether channel summary. And we're looking, and let's bring this down a little bit so we can see more of it. D means down. So it was SD before. It was SD before, but now it's SU, which is in use. And S is layer 2. Capital S is layer 2. If it would be a layer 3, we have an R. Okay, but it's not, it's an S. So, and you pay attention obviously to the protocol and to the ports that are involved in the channel. So show Ethernet channel summary is the command you need to be aware of. And they're asking you what protocol are you using to negotiate across the Ether channel. Well, there you go. You're using Lightning. And that means you can go across vendors. It's not specific just to Cisco. That is your Ether channel. That's it. Is this? Don't think more into it. Don't think more into it. That is the kind of questioning that there are line of questioning that you may encounter. If they make you configure, well, there you go. Replicate this 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Redo it over and over again. You'll be good to go. All right. But I got a boot camp coming up on the 17th and the 18th. Go to globed.net. And check it out, because I have a boot camp. It's going to be for 6 hours on Saturday, 6 hours on Sunday, all right, on specific topics. It's not the whole ICMD1 and ICMD2. You know how to read. I'm not going to tell you the OSI model, Cisco Theater of the Modern, and all that. But you need to know your routing protocols and how to configure them and certain things within the routing protocols. You need to know about layer 2, okay? You need to know about HSRP. You need to know about NAT, which are simple. All right, HSRP, redundancy protocols, all these different things, specific topics. that we can go over. Okay, so if you're looking for it, 2 days, August 17th and August 18th, just go to globet.net. Go to globet.net. It'll show you there the times. Okay, I know it's the 17th and the 18th, Saturday and Sunday, but go to globet.net so you can look at the time. But that's it. That's it for Etherchannel. Okay, real world, hey man, whatever else you do in the real world, that's a different story, but you need that piece of paper. So pay attention to this lab and do it over and over and over again until you get it. I'll see you in the boot camp, hopefully, but if not, in the next episode.